Well, awards, accolades, and trophies is what we are talking about today on Legit Hustlers. Join us as we talk to Bonventure Asimwe, the brain behind most of the awards that you see being given out at functions here in Kampala and beyond. My name is Brenda Kembabazi. Welcome to Legit Hustlers. Welcome very much, Bonventure, to this show.
Thank you very much.
Okay, we're glad to host you. And the people out there would want to know, in a nutshell, who is Bonventure Asimwe?
Bonventure Asimwe is a visual artist, and I'm 31 years of age. I've been practicing for the last 5 years. Yes, and I graduated with Bachelor's of Industrial and Fine Arts from College of Engineering, Design, Art and Technology, Makerere, okay, in 2012.
Okay. So just to take you a little back, take us through the kind of education and family that you were raised in.
Wow, that's a very interesting one. It's such a huge story, but passed on when I was young. My dad, I was around 8, and my mom, I was around 13. I am rooted in a strong Catholic family, so, and the Catholic, even from prehistoric, there are people who used to support the arts, because you could see from the history of art, most of the people who would commission were would be Catholics and stuff like that. So my parents had hired a self-taught artist who painted in our house. So my first instincts of attempting to do things, to experiment with art, was just imitating a few paintings which were in-house. Then I tried to draw them outside, either on sand or on the wall. So when my parents passed on, I was raised by different people. I was a disciplined child, and who was at the same time very religious, so I would get different people to pay for my fees at different levels. Growing up, I didn't want to be an artist, much as I had exhibited skills at a much tender age, because at the age of 7, 8, I would experiment making rubber stamps from gumboots. I would make stools. I would make this thing where they make mwenge bigere and milk guards. I was pretty much hands-on.
Yeah.
I would fix saucepans. I would repair jerry cans. Yeah, so that was my humble childhood. So most times when a client engages me, they have their preferred design. Most times, there are those clients who come for the first time and they have no clue what they want. So they challenge you to submitting in several sketches till when they are comfortable with one and they say, go ahead. For this particular project, which is a work in progress, my client had a preferred design, which she sent to me, and I had to reinterpret it on my computer, then get some dimensions, then before I started making a mold from which I'll make her final work.
So the work starts from your computer?
You most times, yes, sure. Because some people are keen on detail, some want dimensions, even weight, color. So the simulation you provide them on computer for the approval is exactly what you execute.
Take us through the process.
Okay. Like I explained before, this is work in progress. There are some bits which I will add up to make one complete whole. These are going to be stars. This is going to be the body, and this one will be a base.
So what kind of material is this that
you use? This is car body filler. It comes in this tin. So it's a very strong material and it sets very fast. You would consider it to be one of the fast drying materials. So you have to be one, very quick and fast, and two, keen, because the moment you miss out a detail, you'll have to fight hard to get it to the shape you want. I'm going to fix the two stars together so that I get a slightly thicker dimension here. Before this hardener is added, it takes quite some time to set. By the moment I drop in this red, then I have to be very fast. So that's why I need my tools, gloves, before I put the hardener. And remember, if there is any balance on what you mix, then you have to pour it.
There's a process that takes about how long on average?
Of mixing this?
No, like making an accolade.
It depends, because making an accolade, there are a series of steps. So it depends on how many you're making and which material you're using.
So you actually do measurements to make those cutouts?
Yes, yes, at some point. You have to leave reserve for trimming. You can't make exact, you know, measurement because there is shrinkage. Sometimes the material shrinks. You need to smoothen it. So if you make the exact dimension, then you're likely going to reduce its body as you refine. So you have to be aware of shrinkage and other processes that might eat up the body. So, and two, you don't have to be to use all the material. Because you have mixed your material, you want to use it all, you might end up, you know, spoiling what you've done. So when you have, for example, captured the basic you want to capture, you let that material waste as you refine what you have. So that's why, like right now, I have to leave this here, and I first wait for this to set, then I trim, then I will add some more material later.
So how long does it take for these to set?
It's already set. It's setting, rather, actually. And actually, when it starts setting, it emits heat. It can be extremely hot. Then that's when you know that it's setting. Then, of course, it gets stiff.
So what kind of material is that you've been using to smear the coating?
This one, it comes with body filler. When they are selling this thing, people who work on dented cars, they use the same material to fix them. So these come with the tin you buy. They actually give you this and two of these. So at this point, I can use my cutter to trim off these.
So the material is readily available here in Uganda?
Yeah, sure. Because garages, you know, mechanics use the same material. So there is a material that is close to this, which is called resin. It's what I've found lacking around here. Now my next step is to fill these gaps so that you don't see the joinery.
So it's all the same material that you're using?
Yeah, it's all the same material. Because I'm preparing a mold. Sometimes this is not the final product. This helps you to make a pattern which you can hide in the sand, and then you melt metals and pour in there. At every step, you have to first clean. You can't forget to clean the or to shape. Otherwise, you'll come when the thing is too hard to, when the material is too hard to be trimmed.
So what is that you do?
I don't know how to explain it. I want to have these spaces covered. So you have to use a fresh material and then you cut.
Well, at this point, what Asimwe has done is he has made pillars out of filler, which he's going to be placing on this base, and he'll add to the top stars that will hold the top of this accolade. I can't wait to see the final product from what he is making. So Asimwe, I think our filler is now
set. Yes, yeah. Sure, it is.
So do you do all of this work alone, or do you get to employ some people at
times? I employ people, actually, but for this particular step, I do it myself.
Okay.
Because you can't guarantee accuracy from a worker you haven't trained for long. So there are simple things they can do for me. But at the point of building a pattern, I always do it myself. Actually, in here, body filler can sit in comfortably. So these are going to be enhancers. So I'll drill in here. I also put filler here. But filler has an adhesive contact with this other filler, but this will be an enhancer of strength. So it's what I'm going to do next.
So you use a particular size of nail when you're drilling?
It depends, because now what I want is a space big enough to accommodate this. Mm-hmm. So I have to use a bit that is slightly bigger.
So what you're mixing now is what you're going to put in the bases to fit on.
To first,
this.
You know, enhancers, which are the nails, also need to be firmly positioned. Eh?
So how come the filler is able to fit on wood?
When you are making choice of material to work with, you have to be cautious of the adhesive compatibility. So when you're using adhesives like epoxy, the one I'm going to show you, you are sure rubber, metal, wood, everything. So is a body filler.
So filler matches with any type of material?
Not any type, but wood. Yeah, it works with wood. Okay. And metal.
Which one would you say is more durable, using wood or using metal?
Metal, of course, is the most, you know, what's the word?
Durable.
The most durable. But when the client, one, has limited time, because the challenge we get, they engage you when it's almost 2 days to the event. These are what they expected tomorrow. So, and most of those clients are not briefed how much time it takes you to execute, say, a work in brass. So you tell them, much as this is a product that looks better, the time we have can't afford us to do this.
I think we work on this one and finish this one.
No, at that point now, I can use grinders to shape whatever.